guys, welcome back to another episode of Sleeping Giants. Now, in the last episode, we had a 4-1 victory over Borac, and we really did start to extend our lead at the top. Now, we've only had two games this month, because I know you guys wanted to see the FK Partizan game, so that is what we're going to do. They are second in the league, but as you're going to see in a minute, we could pretty much wrap the title up, not quite really, but in today's game, so it is getting to that stage of our dominance. So in our first game, and I've also got something else to talk about. In our first game, we played against Jagodina, and this was a strange one, because you remember how good they were last year and the struggles we had against them. Today, it was not quite so much. We really did do very, very well. We had to substitute our goalkeeper after 11 minutes when Carriman picked up a knock, which was annoying. But, you know, Stankovic did an okay job at times, but not the best towards the end. Bosancic put us in front on 31 minutes, actually from a corner, which is great. He hasn't scored in a few games, so it was nice to see him get himself back on there. He's still got 18 goals this season, which is unbelievable stuff from him. Darko Lazovic then made it 2-0 to us just after half-time, which was even better. Coming in off that right-hand side, he's got a decent amount of goals. 8 goals for the season in total as well, which is lovely. And finally, on 49 minutes, Georgi Despotovic, who of course also has a decent amount of goals with 15 this season, stepped in and made it 3-0. Now, we were dominating the game up until the last few minutes of this game when, I have to say, the goalkeeper should have done better for the one of those guys, I can't remember which one it was. Ball comes in for a sort of wide cross, and it's practically on the goal line, and like right in the centre of the goal, and the keeper just starts backing away to the point where he's inside the net, and then the defender has to bring it down for some reason, even though the keeper could just catch it. He's inside his net, like standing right at the back of the net, and then the attacking player just slide tackles it in. It was ridiculous. All the keeper had to do was pick the ball up. Very, very frustrating, but we won the game 3-2, and just about got away with that one, so it was a little bit tight in that game. In our next game, things weren't quite so tight. It was the derby against OFK, and two of our sort of younger stars, and Avramovsky has been so good lately, scored that wonderful hat-trick. I think it was a hat-trick. Either he got the hat-trick or... No, he scored those wonderful two goals against PSV, as well as the two assists, but 12 minutes in, put us in the lead, and Vukozin Jovanovic also managed to get in there and score another. Now, Savicevic is very nearly fit again. I don't think he's going to be ready for today's game, but he might be ready for the ones in the next episode. The match stats here, as you can see, we were definitely dominant and absolutely deserved to win. Now, what this has done for the league, though, is we're now 12 points clear. Partizan lost. Oh, who was it against? They lost against Radnicki. Who aren't bad, but Partizan are having some really wobbly performances in games at times this year, and as much as they're 7 points clear of third place, they are 12 points behind us, and just, there's no hope in hell of them catching us now. They are 12 points clear. Even if they beat us today, they'd still be 9 points behind with 7 games to go, and probably still a worse head-to-head. A win for us today would put us 15 points ahead of them with 7 games left, as well as having a better head-to-head record. They'd need to claw about 16 points. We could pretty much do whatever we like for the rest of the season, and I may well start playing some younger players and like doing full squad rotations for the last few games of the season. Not because I'm taking the piss or anything, just because I want to give some of these guys, people like Ljubisa Dufedzic, a chance to really shine, and maybe some league football could really help with that. So yeah, that's my plan on that front. Now, there is one piece of business that is a little bit worrying, and that is something that has happened to one of our players. Now, some of you may have seen me talk about this on Twitter. I did post a screenshot of it, which is something I've never seen before, and that is this. This is Nepeshnik, as you would know. He has got a serious viral infection, and is expected to be out for 7 to 8 months, to the point where I've had to unregister him, because he's never going to play for us this season, and would be very lucky if he plays for us again this year. It's a big shame. I mean, the fact is, it actually is quite a blow at times, because he's played a lot of... He can play in a lot of positions, and he has done for us because we've had so many injuries. Now, he's not always a starter. He's more of a sort of backup, but still, for any player to have that kind of injury, 7 to 8 months with a serious viral infection, that is horrible. And think how much his stats are going to decline in there, because he is 30. So some genuine worries there for Nepeshnik. I wish he told you what it was, but serious viral infection, I mean, that could be anything, but 7 to 8 months, that is horrible. So yeah, our hearts go out to you and your family. Get well soon. Now, That, well, while we're here, we may as well talk about the squad. Top goal scorer, of course, is Milos Bosancic with 18, but Despotovic has 15, which is also fairly decent, considering the amount of games he's actually started. And Abramovsky's done very well as well, considering the amount of games he's started. He's only started 14 times. He's got 9 goals and 12 assists. There's a lot of assists in this team. Abramovsky has 12, Lazovic and Gavrich have 11, and Pešnik himself has 10. If Savicevic can come back and get himself a goal, that'd be 5 players with more than 10 assists. That's pretty impressive. Player of the match, that is, well, Bosancic, Savicevic, Lazovic, and Abramovsky all tying for that one. Pass rating, Hushti has actually done okay, and I've learned that it is in fact pronounced Hushti. No one's yet been able to tell me how to pronounce his first name, but I'm still going to go as Shazbolsh. I sound more and more like Sean Connery the more that we're going to build a speedboat. The more I say that. Right. So yeah, it's Hushti, and we shall just call him Hushti from now on. For now, until someone corrects me. So, yellow card. Yeah, Kovacevic and Mihailovic and Jovanovic have 6 each. And the red cards, of course, Lazic, Jovanovic and Planic. We've been not bad for that this year. Average rating is, of course, still Savicevic because of that wonderful start he had. I'm looking forward to him next year. That is all I can say. I did look into some of the players people suggested. I did check out Babic. I can't remember who suggested me this. I did know about him, but at the time, I knew that his release clause was 1.7 million, but at the time, we didn't have the money because of our first season. Unfortunately, in the summer, he signed for Anderlecht. He's now on loan at FK Partizan, but yeah, he plays for Anderlecht. I put a bid in for him of 1.7, which is his value as well now, and they wanted 14 million quid for him, so he's out of the window. But don't worry, I'm going to go and try and bring some people in. I have got some in mind as well, so we'll talk about that when we get to the summer, though, because we are starting to look for players, if nothing else. Now, we may as well get into today's game. Why the hell not? So today we're against Partizan. We are away from home, so they could still beat us here. And I wouldn't be surprised if they did, frankly. But I just think, look, I mean, we've got a fairly strong side. Despotovic, Abramovsky, Gavrich, Bosancic, Lazovic, Antic, Planic, Jovanovic, Petkovic, Kovacevic, and Karaman. The only player, oh no, so I was going to say the only player without itch. But no, Abramovsky and Karaman, they are itchless. They are not itchy. But if you notice on the bench, Ljubica Cvetic, that'd be interesting. Savicevic, as you can see, he's not fully match fit yet. That's his the main problem for him. And his conditioning's poor, but that's because he's been playing in some of our under-21 games to try and get his match fitness back. We should see him before the end of the season, but we can't expect too much from him just yet. So, let's go for this. Let's just see what we can do. Like, I would like to avoid defeat, because we've only lost 3 guys this entire season. But even if we do lose, it really doesn't make that much difference to us, in all honesty. It's good to have Cvetic on the bench, because he's the guy that I'm really looking at as sort of like, I want him to be the third choice guy in terms of Savicevic, Abramovsky, Cvetic, because he could probably be better than them. But for now, I want him to be at least good enough to be able to play there if we do get a number of injuries there, which we seem to be able to quite comfortably. Although I'm going to work on training stuff over the summer. So we're going to do intensive fitness training during preseason and then nice low intensity stuff during the season to really try and make sure that they've got decent levels of fitness and they don't get too jaded during the season and don't fall susceptible to injuries. That is sort of the guide that I've been using, and I'm going to try that out in the summer here. So hopefully next year we can be much stronger, as well as by signing a few players, because I'm hoping we're going to get, I don't know, 3 or 4 million in transfer budget would be quite nice for me. Oh, ball over the back post. Gavrich is in there, and it is 1-0 to Red Star Belgrade in the very first minute. In the third minute of the game, Partizan 0, Red Star 1, and oh, if we could humiliate them on their own ground, no offense to anyone who's a Partizan fan watching this, I do apologize, but the point is we're managing Red Star, so you got to get behind it. You don't see me complaining when we beat Fulham. Lovely stuff here from Despotovic. Rolls it out here, and Lazovic with a long ball just dropping it perfectly. And the keeper probably could have come for that, but there we go. 1-0 to Red Star, and that is the perfect start for us. Hopefully that's a sign of things to come for today's game. They're not just going to immediately go and concede directly off the end of that. Don't just let him through. There we go. Good stuff. Carryman with the long ball forward, and Despotovic should be able to win that header. He doesn't, and there's Babic at the back, the guy I was on about a second ago. There's 3 players around him. Somebody win the ball off of him. Nope. Okay. Just watch the runs. Oh, you should have been doing better there. You should have been doing better. Planet should have had that. Yorda's 25th goal of the season. They may not be doing so well. But the thing for me, though, is that we're getting goals from all over the pitch. They seem to have very much their goals come from Skulatic and, obviously, Yorda. Luka there with... I think Planet could have cut that out, and then the keeper probably could have done better with it, but it is now 1-1 after just 6 minutes. Wow, every shot on target has so far gone in the net. Oh, don't let this just get flipped on us immediately. That would be horrible. Put a tackle in somebody. Oh, my days. Right, okay. That was a short-lived piece of... Right. That was unbelievable. I can't believe we just let that happen. You take a great lead in a game against your big rivals and then just sort of slowly let them walk through you. What are you doing defensively? There's a guy right there, and yet he just lets the... We may have to use tighter marking, or do we already have that on? Yep. Okay. Here's an idea. When I say use tighter marking, potentially try using tighter marking by actually marking them tighter. Go on, let's get an equaliser here. Just make it 2-2 after 20 minutes. Reset the game. Gavrich has a guy out on his left. Oh, he can't find it. Kovacevic, now he does. Antic, first time ball, maybe? He does get a first time cross, and it's clear, but down to Bosancic. What a strike! Oh, it's to Spotovic, and that's in the net. That looked offside. I think that's... Yeah, it is offside. He's offside. Oh, damn it. I thought that was going to be us right back in the game. That would have been perfect. That would have wiped away any... So why was Despotovic allowed to get himself offside there? Oh, right. Because it hit the... Oh, bugger. If that hadn't have hit our player, that's a pain. But... Surely he was behind the ball. It looked like he was behind the ball. Oh, well. Let's see if we can get ourselves back... Oh, that's poor. That's really poor. I suppose it's because we've got pass into space on. It's just one of those things that's going to happen, isn't it? Don't just let them slide him through again. Are you kidding me? That is ridiculous. 3 shots on target, 3 goals. What are we doing? Defensively, this is shocking. They're just letting him walk through every single time. What is the point of having a shield player there if he's just going to allow this? I don't know what he stepped up for. Like, what is he trying to defend? No one closed him down, all right? Close down less, perhaps? I'm going to turn that off so we try and keep a bit more of the ball, because at the moment, I don't think we deserve to be 3-1 down in this game for now. They've had 3 clear cut chances, but we let them. Yes, he does keep escaping attention, because apparently we have the attention span of a gnat. I can't believe we're trailing this game. Well, and I can, because we're not playing all that well, but I'm just surprised that they've been able to score that many goals with that few amount of chances. I'd love it if we could do that now. Antic is ball in. That's just going to go straight to the goalkeeper. Don't just let them go down the other end and score now. We've had nearly the same amount of shots as them, but they've not been as good in terms of creating the chances. Lukács now. He's dropped it down. We're going to have to go for it in the second half. And frankly, we're in a position now with our league form where we can probably afford to throw caution to the wind a little bit and just have a little bit of fun. Again, he's just completely unmarked. Thank you. Jesus Christ. Right. Who are you? Jovanovic, right. I'm sorry, but this is getting stupid now. Not even joking. Right, Vukasin Jovanovic. Really? Because you're not doing a very good job of it. What's your marking stat? 13. You should be doing much better than that. And is it? He's escaped attention again. I mean, what's the point? I don't understand. What can I do about that? I've got them specifically set to mark this guy, like, ridiculously, and they just constantly leave him alone. He's marked him tight, and then, oh, he's just left him. Yeah, that's a great idea. And then he's through on goal again, and it's 4-1 to them. I don't really see how they... Oh, Jesus. Right, we're going to have to sort out some stuff at half-time and really reshuffle this to really kick on and go for this in the second half. Right. I can't believe a 3-1... A 4-1 down, that's insane. Right. And that would actually give them a slightly better head-to-head. Not to be alarmist, but it would. No, I'm not going to shoot on sight. I'm not going to work into the box either. We are going to close down more. We are going to push higher up because we need to try and condense the space. I am going to overload for the entire second half because that has actually worked for us in the past. We just have no choice really now. We're already on attacking, so we can't go any more attacking than we already are. I'm not going to throw extra strikers or anything like that because I find that just makes it worse. I just don't think we're worthy of being 4-1 behind. I mean, they've put the ball in the net. Fair play to them on that, but Christ, our defending has been woeful. Well, then... I've not got you set to shoot from that distance. Come on. Oh, thank right. That's their striker out injured, Rafa Jorda. See what changes I can make when we get to the point of making the substitution. Right, we can't get shots on goal. That's something we definitely need to do. Avramovsky's knackered, frankly, so we're going to bring on Tufedzic, because why the hell not? Maybe the kid can come up with something a little bit special for us. I'm going to tell him to push forward. I'm going to adjust the tactics slightly if I can finally get this... Right, we'll do a quick team talk as well. Just tell him to push the hell forward, because... Yeah, I'd rather just try and get a couple of goals and just try and earn some respect out of this game, because it's been a very poor defensive display up until now. Right, what have we got? I'm putting my wingers on attack, just so they'll drive at them a little bit more. Risk, maybe, but I'd rather have some more attacking players, just trying to get at them a little bit. Because we've got quite decent wingers, so we may as well try to utilise them. Another substitution. Strakwalersi's coming on because he's done very little. And Djordjevic, I'm going to bring him on for Planic because he's been pretty poor. And he's knackered. So let's get them both on. I can't believe we're losing this 4-1. I mean, 12 shots apiece. They've had a couple more on target. They've created better chances, but that's just purely down to our defending. It's been absolutely awful. Right, Antic. Ball into Basancic. Knock back for Gavrić. Gavrić, assuming it's going to go back to Basancic. Now push forward, people. Get yourselves forward. Tufedzic, down for Basancic. Tufedzic is making a run now. That's better. Can he? Well, he won't be a hero for us unless he scores a hat-trick. And oh, for the love of God. What are you doing? Like, why are you shooting from there? All right, now I'm going to say shoot from anywhere you like. But point is, I didn't have that on before. And that particular role is not instructed to shoot more. That's where Basancic plays. He's instructed to shoot more because he can actually fucking shoot from long range. I've actually got my wingers told to shoot less. We've actually had more shots than them. Impressive. So we've kept him quiet in the second half, but they couldn't be asked to do... Oh, my Lord. I thought I was going to roll through and he'd score from it. It's a disappointing result, really, when you look at the stats for the game, but they've created better chances. It's as simple as that, really. And we allowed them to, and that's what makes it most... annoying is that we allowed them to create those chances. Tufedzic now drops it through for Strakwalersi. He's had a goal. What a strike. I mean, he's good for that kind of thing, Strakwalersi. He really can hit one from that kind of distance. So it's 4-2, but does that mean Tufedzic is going to get an assist for that? Yeah, I think he is. Lovely little turn from Strakwalersi, and then the beautiful strike. He's done that a few times this season, but it's too late. It's just too late for anything of that sort. Or is it probably not too late for them to score a fifth, though? That would be embarrassing. Although, if we can win the ball off them and get a third goal, that would at least make the game look a bit more respectable. And show that they... Oh, he's just going to slide it straight into that guy. Well done. It's going to come straight back to him. Somebody just put a tackle in your... Anybody. Thank God for that. He's missed a golden opportunity there because nobody would actually put a tackle in on him. And we're set to get stuck in, I think. No, we're not. Okay, that makes sense. But get stuck in doesn't mean you can't tackle if you haven't got that set on. I tell you what, we could win this here. Except we've just let them win it instead. Pretty sure that's their fullback that just won that ball and took it out of the air. Markovic, Luka, and that will probably do it. 4-2 is a disappointing result when you look at the stats for this game. I don't think we were 4-2 bad. Although, defensively, we were. Genuinely woeful, and that's a real shame. But still, we're still 9 points clear at the top of the league. It's just a shame to lose a game like that, really. We've got some slightly easier games coming up now for the rest of the season. So I think we'll have no problems wrapping up the league, probably within the next episode. In fact, we might well be doing in the next live comment, might actually be the one where we wrap up the league, frankly, because of the way things have been going. Let's just take a little look at how many... Well, we're 9 points clear. There's 7 games to go. We've got... In the next episode, it'll be the rest of April, so we've got Mladost, Vojvodina, and those same... So yeah, we could be looking at wrapping it up. If we can win all of them, we could be looking at wrapping up the league in the next episode in the live comp. So guys, if you like what you've seen, please feel free to drop a like on the episode, and if you'd like to even more than that, please feel free to subscribe to my channel for more Portsmouth and Red Star Belgrade in your inbox every single day at 5:30 and 8 o'clock, and I will see you guys in the next episode for the FK Rad game. Bye-bye.